What's up, everyone? I'm the Kaiju no Kami here at Kumoricon 2019 with
Kelly Kain.
And we are interviewing
Tia Ballard.
For those who might not know what you are from or who are you and what are you from?
Well, it's a long story, but I'll go with the cartoon aspect of my life. Who am I? Okay, where am I from? Happy the Cat from Fairy Tale. 02 and Darling in the Franks. Oh my gosh, and a slew of others.
So much more.
So many others. Oh my gosh.
You don't know them all off the top of your head?
Unfortunately, I don't. When you hit 100 and then you go past 200, it's like, all these children, what do I do with you?
It makes me wonder, I think, for any voice actor, but including yourself, how do you sleep? You do so many voices. Do you always hear them in your head after time and time again?
I have trouble sleeping, but it's only because I have so many interests in so many projects. Not just voice, but I also draw, I also write, I direct, I plant, I'm a master gardener. The list goes on.
Which I find fascinating because before I start any interview, I always like to kind of get an idea of what a person likes to do. Because I don't want to just talk about, oh, you're this character, you're that character. I want to be able to give everyone an opportunity to know a little bit more about you.
Thank you.
And so I guess the first thing I'd like to ask is somebody with a black thumb who apparently can kill any plant in existence, any pointers as a master gardener of how they keep things alive?
The most frequent mistake that I come across is over-loving, which means over-watering. That's what I mean, over-watering. So in life, I feel like people should be over-loved, but plants, they hate it. So most plants, leave them alone and they'll tell you.
That's a good point. I am terrible at probably listening to my plants. Except to, like, cactuses. They seem to...
Cacti?
I'm a teacher. It doesn't mean I know English, but...
We prefer cacti.
But I find that cacti seem to be okay with over-under-loving. It seems like everything else in the known universe, plant-wise.
Yeah, my favorite to grow is ivy because it's easy. It's just like... And you've got these long hair. Well, it's not hair. It's leaves. But it's like hair is like, I don't know. It's awesome. I love plants.
Kind of reminds me of drama in a way.
What?
With plants. Just like so many different types of plants, different styles. I always think of like different stories when I see different plants and going to like botanical gardens.
Oh my gosh. Plants are so temperamental too. In the same way. It's funny when I became a master gardener, friends, of course, when they find out, are like, come help me. Come to this. I can't, but I'll try. You know, I can look at certain things and be like, oh, that's what the problem is. The plant told me. And they look at you like, what did you say? But it's like, they don't speak, but they have their ways.
That is awesome. So, Tia Ballard, the plant whisperer.
I was going to say no.
The druid.
You should do your own gardening show. I'll be like, gardening with Tia.
Oh my gosh. Can you imagine all the gardening, like the real gardeners that are like, no, you're doing it all wrong. Oh, it'd be awful.
That's just like media and social media in general, though.
Oh my gosh, that's true. That's true. I kind of used to that with my job anyway.
So with so many different hobbies and so many different passions, even in the professional realm, you do a lot of voice acting, you do directing, you do screenwriting. How do you balance all three different aspects within your own career?
You don't.
Have you cloned yourself to do each one?
Oh my gosh. I need so many Tias. I need so many Tias. It's a lot of restraint. You have to, you know, you have to make your schedule, but you also have to... And I had a hard time with this for the longest time, but self-care is very important. Just a moment where you're like, no expectations on myself. Push it all away and just be. And read a book and have a bubble bath or whatever. Because as creative people...
Oh, yeah.
It's like, I'm never doing enough. And I've got all these thoughts and I've got all these things I want to do, but I can't do them. And you gotta chill sometimes. You just have to chill. I do all kinds of things. I say about myself, I like turning nothing into something. Okay. So, like, you take a seed and you grow into a plant. Mm-hmm. Or you take a cartoon that's just a base script and you turn it into a full-blown thing. I am building a puppet right now.
Oh, wow.
Because I want to build a puppet. And I was like, I'm going to do that. So I did all this research, and I started building a puppet by hand.
That is awesome.
Yeah, it's just kind of like being okay with making mistakes and saying, hey, it may not turn out, but I won't do this again. You know, that didn't work. Let's see what does. So, yeah.
So what keeps you motivated? Not just the creativity aspect, but are there any other influences that help you stay so driven?
I mean, I think we all have people that we look up to that, mm-hmm. you know, there's Walt Disney, there's Fred Rogers, there's all kinds of people that have just set the bar on being good, creative, kind people.
Mm-hmm.
But also, I feel like as a creative person, you've got this inner burn that is always there. Because you do this, so you're obviously creative. But have you ever, like, seen something, somebody doing what you want to do, and it just hurts your heart? It's just, oh, I want that so badly, it hurts me. Or you watch a show or see something, and it's so beautiful, it just aches.
Oh, yes.
It's just, you're so beautiful, you hurt my feelings. that's what I feel often. And oh, wow. That is what drives me. Just this need to, I got all these feelings inside, and I just need to express them so you know how I'm feeling.
Oh,
and
yeah.
It's all communication. I don't know if that makes sense at all, but I just feel pulled.
No, I think that's a great way of looking at it, especially when you reference Walt Disney, Fred Rogers. You could even put, like, even trying to think of, oh my God, there's, like, so many. Oh, Frank Wells, I think it is.
Oh, are you talking about Frank Weller?
Yeah, Frank Weller. He even has that similar motif, and he's talked about different elements where he is so driven to voice every known character out there just because he loves
Frank Welker.
Being able to try new things or to put new elements into his own voice acting. So it's nice to hear other individuals, even in the modern era, say that because we have technology that makes things so convenient.
Yes.
We have other tools that diminish that creative drive because you can make it more simplistic. So hearing that you even go to more of the grassroots method of researching, building, putting your hands into it, that's incredible.
Thank you so much.
Inspiring at the same time.
Oh, I really appreciate that.
And I think it's important, especially if you don't hear it enough or even if you do, just to always be reminded that it's so nice to still see that.
Right.
Because as creative as anyone can be, if you don't have that drive to learn from start to finish, you're not succeeding. And that's what made all of the greats great.
Right. It's finding that passion.
Yes.
Letting yourself feel it and letting yourself learn as you do the thing. Because you're not going to do the thing right the first time.
Absolutely.
Or the second or the third. You have to grow. And your passion will grow with your talent. And it's amazing, and it's hard, and it's painful.
Oh,
but
sure.
But it's beautiful, too, and I don't know, there's something magical about it. You know, it's the closest thing to, like, creation. Like, the earth, the universe, like, you're making a thing, you're bringing it into being, and that takes some practice.
Mm-hmm. No, I think that's important.
As an educator myself, so you're working on a children's book. What is this book about?
This book is actually based on my dad when he was young. My character is named Reaper. He's got he's actually the one I'm building a puppet of. He's got this wild mane of red hair and this giant front tooth that sticks out. He's super awkward looking. But when my dad was younger, he's a country boy. I'm a country girl, so it's a lot of wildness and things like that. But also kindness. And when he was younger, my dad has, he's dyslexic, and he also has ADHD. And when he was younger, they didn't know how to treat those things.
Oh, never.
And it was very much, you're not motivated. That's what's wrong with you. And that could really stunt someone emotionally as they grow into an adult,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Oh, absolutely.
Those are frightening things to hear, and even as an adult, you're like, well, maybe I'm not motivated. It's like, no, you need help. So my character has those same things, and it's, he doesn't know how to process his emotions. Sometimes he gets over the top, but he's kind and he's good despite that. And just because someone has these struggles and they're learning how to deal with them, they can be loving and warm and good.
That is brilliant, especially even in this day and age that people know how to diagnose it a little bit more. It's still taboo.
Yeah.
So to have something where you can speak to that and feel comfortable, not only introducing personal aspects of your family into that, but also adding in real-world consequences, that's awesome.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. My dad's one of the smartest people I've ever known, and it just breaks my heart to think about, you know, when he was younger. I used to teach kids theater. And, and I had a student that was having difficulty, and no one knew what to do with him. You're just like, he can't... And we don't know how to reach this kid. Just put him in theater. Make him do something. And don't you hate that?
Oh, yeah.
And what I found was when I gave this child a specific purpose, like, this is your part in the show, and no one can do it but you. This is your special.
That's a great way of looking at it.
And he just tunnel vision, focus, and he was there. But, you know, of course... We treat everybody the same. We have this, you know, same expectations for everybody, and somebody's going to get left behind.
Well, and it's sad, but that's the risk, especially in modern classrooms, that you have that potential of students getting left behind because of...
Testing. Everything is about just basically you have to pass this test because that's how we're going to get funding.
Oh, it's so frustrating. When I was getting my teaching degree, just learning, just like, we know this system doesn't work, but we're doing it anyway.
Exactly. Oh. No, when I did my teaching degree, there were many times it made me cry, like thinking about how when I went to school many, many, many moons ago and how it hasn't changed at all in 30 years. And so it's nice to see so many individuals, especially when they have a platform, being able to talk about it and be able to present it, especially the positivity aspect.
Thank you.
Because I think that gets forgotten, and I was going to ask what helps keep you positive, but it sounds like your dad has been a huge influence on presenting that positivity.
My family overall is supportive, like... They've always been supportive. They're wild country folks, so they've got a lot of opinions.
Well,
but at the end of the day, I know they love me, and they'll support all of my crazy ideas. And there's something to be said about that.
Oh, absolutely.
And in this world, I feel like you have to learn how to... You got to figure out how to pull out your own positivity and your own joy, even if it's your... I don't know, if it's an app on your phone... Or something that brings you just a little spark of joy inside that's yours.
I think that's brilliant.
Yeah, you got to. But you really do. You always have to choose. It's a choice.
It is. I think that's a great way of putting it. It's a choice at the end of the day of what you want to do and what you will do. And I think for everyone at home, the important thing that I think we're learning here today is stay positive. Your dreams can be achieved. Just put some effort, put some positivity into it, and don't give up.
Absolutely. And I would say always choose the kindest thing, because the world's hard. The world's hard, and feelings are hard, and people can be painful, and they can be hurtful. And
yes,
you should always, before you react to anything, pause. What's the kindest way to react? What's the kindest way to act? And I think that will, it's an upward trajectory. Like, it'll help you get to where you're going to go. It sounds such a simple concept, but it's difficult in today's world.
So we are out of time. What social media links can people find you at?
I'm at, on Twitter, Tia Tooney. Tooney as in cartoon. Tia Tooney. My art and my puppet head is on Instagram, Tia Tooney, and my photo blog is Instagram, Miss Ballard.
Thank you so much.
Thank
for
you
your
so
time.
Much. Oh my gosh, this Thank interview you. Was so fun. It wasn't about voice acting at all. It was so fun.
Until next time.
Bye.
Bye.